Hey, this is SYDTKO with Curse, and I'm here with SYDTKO, and today we're going to go over the patch notes, so let's get started. So this is the Hecarim patch notes. It's been like 4 weeks, I think, since the last patch, or more.
Yeah, it's been a while.
First, we're just going to kind of go through the list and talk about it. So Akali buff, what's your opinions on that?
It's nice because it brings back some of her survivability, but it's not going to bring her back into favor because her damage is still really gimp compared to what it used to be, so...
The next one, the big one, is Kayle changes. I know she's not been really played all that terribly much here recently, but I think this aims to bring her back into the game a little bit more.
I personally feel like the rework on Kayle is what killed her. She was actually really good before they reworked her, and then they reworked her into something that doesn't really scale really well, and her base values are really poor. So this is aimed at bringing her base values up, but I don't see it really bringing her back into favor because there's too many good choices for support like Lulu, Janna, and the other sustains, so.
All right. So next up is Janna got a slight nerf and sort of a buff, and I'm not really sure what do you think it's going to do to the game for her?
I think everyone's still gonna be in love with Janna because Janna's, well, she's a good hero, but she's only got one real weakness, and that's her lack of sustain. But it's, that's really just aimed at reducing how much CC time Janna actually has if you look at the patch notes.
Right.
So, I'm not sure how the Hailing Gale knockup's gonna function, but it looks like it's going from 1 second to 0.8 second or something like that.
Yeah, maybe it's aimed to stop you from spamming it constantly whenever you're trying to run away and get the mech. Alright, the next up is Orianna's little buff. I don't really see her played that much. Do you think it's gonna change it at all?
That really helps her a lot, but the real problem with what they've done since through all of Orianna's history is that they've consistently lowered her attack range on her Q. So that like makes it really hard to poke with her. I know like players like Salz will be playing her really well, and she's still a good hero, but I don't know. She just doesn't feel as good as she used to be.
Okay, next was Sejuani. Got a pretty good buff all around. What do you think about her?
I think she's really good, and the changes that they've put on her are what she needs, which is she has a really low base mana pool, so having high mana cost is a little bit ridiculous, and that's on the charge that they lowered the mana cost.
Okay, so she can engage a little bit and get around a little bit better on that.
Yeah, you can charge over walls for better ganks and things like that if you have more mana.
Okay.
Glacial Prison cooldown, that will help her early ganks, which are amazing, but you can't do them often. It's like a Moo Moo. You can only do it once every 3 minutes. It's absurd.
Alright, and then you have Teemo. That's a big change going on right now, as Teemo has had lots of different buffs. They've also fixed his bug on his attack speed, which... in turn really makes him gives him a big buff too.
Yeah, they fixed the how the DOT functions on Toxic Shot, and they buffed Move Quick again, which Move Quick used to be on like a 14 second cooldown, and everyone hated Teemo then because he was like niddly and you could never catch him. But yeah, they gave him a nice damage buff by fixing the issue with Toxic Shot, so maybe he'll be popular. I don't know.
Yeah, he's played on and off, but maybe this will give people drive to actually play him a little bit more often.
Yeah, I feel a lot of people play him just because he's a cutesy type, but maybe people play him because he's okay.
Yeah, like we've seen like all the people at the Riot booth and such with the Teemo hats.
Yeah, yeah.
Then you have Zillion buff. Do you think that was really necessary, and do you think it's going to change?
No. That's so unnecessary. I still feel like Zillion's one of the most overpowered heroes in the game, so... he doesn't really need buffs, but it makes it so maybe you can alter your build away from a Rod of Ages, mm-hmm. So that would make him quite a bit stronger.
Okay. So next up, there's a ton of different items that have been nerfed and buffed in the patch, so let's go through them, and I'll start with the Atma's Impaler. Next.
Atma's Impaler, I can see why they nerfed it. It's because you get, for the items that you buy, you get damage suddenly when you convert with the recipe. Like, so it doesn't make sense how much stats you actually get for buying the item, so it makes a lot of sense to nerf it.
Okay, and then there was a nerf to both the Dorne's blade, and I think Dorne's ring got the nerf.
Yep. These are, like, early game changes aimed at, like, I guess that hurts all of the lanes, because top tends to buy Dorne's swords,
yeah.
Bot buys Dorne's swords, mid buys Dorne's rings, and that's aimed at making it so if you're ahead of Dorne's ring, it doesn't mean quite as much, so you still have kill potential on people.
Okay, maybe people won't be buying like three of them in the
yeah,
match.
Yeah, that too. And stacking them so powerful for the gold. Like the gold cost for the stats is so good.
Yeah, because I know that whenever I play, I'll usually get two or three of each one and then towards the end of the game sell them. But it kind of stinks because then I spend the majority of the game just buying those things and then hoping I can sell them later. And I'm like, why is there other yeah. items when I'm done in 20 minutes?
Yeah, the thing about Dorne's too is that they're the only items in the game with a half sellback. The other items have 70%, so it hurts you more when you sell them back compared to every other item. So it's unfortunate to nerf them, but they do need nerfs. So.
Okay. The next up is Hex Drinker's passive. I think it's reduced from or actually increased from 3 to 5
yep.
duration wise.
Yep.
What do you think that's going to do? Make people buy the item less?
the item's still really good right now because it converts into Maw of Malmortius, but it's just a kind of like when you have the Hex Drinker part, it helps you a little bit more. So it's not huge, but it's nice.
Okay, Wit's End cost was increased, I think, yep. by 150 gold.
Yep. The item gave you 42 magic damage on conversion from the items, so the item was just really overpowered, and like it's still probably really overpowered for what it gives you. So nerfing it's fine with me.
All right, yeah. The next up is a little animated combat text change, a little bit higher resolution I think on some things. I think the announcement system got to change. Most of these are cosmetic. Do you think they're gonna help at all, like gameplay wise for you?
I don't really make decisions based on the interface, honestly. I make decisions on how I've previous played the game and what I feel I can get away with, so no, it's I don't play based off the interface really.
So it's just kind of a nice thing to be able to
yeah.
see.
Right. Yeah.
And I guess maybe that's more or less the glory factor for the announcement system.
Yep.
Pentakill.
Yep. It was really yeah. I've seen so many pentakills where it doesn't announce a pentakill and people get upset, so
I would be
fun.
Sad. Yeah. I think I've had one or two that have not been announced.
Yeah.
That and Quadra Kill sometimes get also shoot off to the side and you don't hear them.
Yep.
Okay, the next thing is masteries are being put on server side. So in other words, whenever you switch computers, you have them go with you. Does that change anything for you? I realize a lot of pros generally just keep them, doesn't really matter, they just change them every game.
I keep 10, but all... There's always the nuanced situation where you want, like, a very small change in points, so it's not for that, but it's pretty nice if you're, like, moving around computers. That's really all I can say.
Yeah, I move around a lot, so
yeah.
I guess it's useful for me.
It's nice for you, yeah. I never leave my computer, so it doesn't matter for
See,
me.
See, I don't leave my computer, but I've got one over there, and one over there, and nice. One over there. So it's nice that if I have to jump around that for recording stuff, it helps. Especially for like the casual player, I assume. Let's see, there's been a lot of rune changes here recently. A lot of nerfs as far as coming to being aggressive. What are your thoughts on those changes and how you think it's going to affect the game?
It's actually a nerf to like trying to farm for endgame, because it's what you would do is you would put those MR runes into your blues and you'd have 13 MR. And, like, you can't die in lane with those. So the changes that they're making to the runes are making that MR less and the early AP better. And the early magic pen rune.
So more fun
so,
and damage, basically.
Yeah, yeah. It's geared at making kill conversion more likely in lane. At mid lane.
All right.
Mostly.
Yeah, okay. So basically to help speed up the game in the center. To
yep.
make sure that doesn't... maybe that you see more kill action and less...
Yep.
Power hugging and killing creeps.
Yeah.
Probably one of the most important changes, though, is probably those ruin changes in this patch.
Yep. It's the biggest change to the gameplay, I would say, to every mid player, because it's a pretty... Well, it might change your, like, how you're going to play mid, which is, I want to kill you all the time, instead of, I want to farm.
Okay, also in this patch, like probably one of the biggest changes other than the ruins is the new way that they're doing XP and gold rewards. So whenever a champion kills another champion that's higher level than they are by, I think, like two levels, there's going to be more experience given. There's also more maximum bounty for getting wiping out somebody's killing streak, and experience split is now a little bit better for those who help somebody kill somebody. What are your thoughts on that? Do you think it's going to make the game last longer? Do you think it will really help supports or really just allow people to come back?
It always helps supports because supports will always be underleveled just by matter of the fact that they're going to be like roaming around the map and warding. So they'll miss like waves of XP. But as for making the game length longer, it's hard to say. It gives more potential for recovery, but you still actually have to make those plays to recover. So when you're ahead, it's like easy to keep bulldozing down their towers with Baron. So it doesn't seem likely that you're gonna like lose a Baron after you get it or something like that. It's not gonna change the game that much.
Once again, this is Sylacus with Curse, and I'm here with SYDTKO, and thanks for the interview, man. I hope we get to do it again.
Yeah, no problem.